Hi guys. Coming back to channel can be quite hard. But I am back with a new series and this time won't bore you with anything. So let's talk about the movie Bullet Train. Released in 2022. Directed by this guy. But who is this? He also directed John Wick 2014. Deadpool 2. Fast and Furious Hobbs and Shaw. Wait, wait, wait. I did not tell you the name of this movie. Please comment which movie you think it is, or if you aren't that bright, I'll give you hints in coming minutes. So the director is David Leitch. Please subscribe to this channel to hear more from me. Until then, let's understand the movie first. Bullet Train. You know it's based on a novel? Yes, a novel which is converted from a Korean book called Maria Beetle, which the writer eventually converted it into English. When released back in 2010, this book was really selling out there. You know, this writer is famous for writing his Hitman / novel manga series like Mao Juvenile Remix, translated as Three Assassins and then featured as film Grasshopper. Released in 2015. Even I haven't seen this film yet. Have you guys watched it already? Please let me know down below. Below? Yes, in the comments sections. Please like while you are already down below. Kōtarō Isaka is the writer for the movie as well as for the book. So what's the story? Let's do a recap in 2 minutes. It revolves around multiple assassins who all boarded the bullet train, and this train is leading to its final destination, where another assassin, or let's say a boss, is waiting to receive the package. Yes, a final boss. So we have Brad Pitt as Ladybug, Aaron Taylor Johnson as Tangerine, and Brain Tyree as Henry Lemon. And there are many, but these are my favorite in this movie, so let's move forward. So first there is a father who boards the train in search of his son's attacker. Here steps as Ladybug to retrieve a briefcase full of cash as a replacement for sick colleague. Where we have two brothers, Lemon and Tangerine, British assassins who are delivering the son to the boss with the briefcase. Now coming fast forward. Briefcase is stolen, many people are killed, the delivery called the son is also poisoned. Now the movie rolls ahead until all of them are killed, or at least someone wins. So please watch the movie. It's really good. Here is the casting. Brad Pitt as Ladybug, an American assassin who is suffering from anxiety and considers himself unlucky. Joey King as the Prince, a manipulative young assassin disguised as a schoolgirl, who seeks vengeance on the White Death. Aaron Taylor Johnson as Tangerine, a British assassin, Lemon's twin brother. Brian Tyree Henry as Lemon, a British assassin, Tangerine's twin brother with an obsession for Thomas the Tank Engine. Andrew Koji as Yuichi Kimura / the father, a Yakuza member whose son Wataru was pushed off a building by the prince. Hiroyuki Sanada as the elder, Yuichi's father and Wataru's grandfather. Yoshi Sadarso as young elder. Michael Shannon as the White Death, a Russian crime lord, who took over a Yakuza group. Benito A. and Martínez Ocasio as the Wolf, a Mexican assassin, who seeks vengeance on the Hornet. Sandra Bullock as Maria Beetle, Ladybug's contact and handler. Zazie Beetz as the Hornet, an assassin who specializes in poisons. Logan Lerman as the Sun, the White Death's son. Masioka as the train conductor. Karen Fukuhara as Kaida Izumi, the concession girl. Now you need to understand that this action movie slowly converted into action comedy film while filming, so there are a lot of bloopers. But before that, let's get into cinematography. Who did it? Jonathan Sila did it. This movie has it all. Amazing fight sequences, are belonging to the Japanese culture, with really cool blade uses, or we can call it katana. Music has brought us more together in the final part, as we are jumping out of our seats waiting for it to all end. So let's take a dive into the best shots that really tell Bullet Train apart from others. Movie incline. The movie is divided into 5 part. The introduction. Mystery arrangement. The mashup. The exits. Final boss fight. Within the first 10 minutes we have completed the part 1 of our story, which is introduction. Second starts by description of characters, the storyline forward. As Lemon and Tangerine talks about fruits and pies, we already knew the action has begun as B04 kills her first victim. As we are unsure if he is dead or not, we move on. Now our subject comes alive, and LNT focuses on building the gap, gap which we would have to fulfill in the future part of the story. So if we listen carefully, this movie is really funny. So first character description by Lemon, and by the way we have to listen to this because it's being described by our character. 1. First is Gordon, who is Tangerine. He says strongest and the most imp, but he doesn't always listen to others. 2. Henry, hardworking and strong.
Some Henrys, hardworking, strong. Some people.
3. Some people are diesels. Listen how he describes this.
Some people are diesels. Fuck me. That was the trouble. You though.
See?
Yeah, you.
That jump of elevation is supposed to bring audiences' mind to Diesel as being negative or imp character, and he stopped. After the elevation, he didn't utter a word, only showed his emotions.
Sweet.
4. He gave the son a Percy tag as being sweet polite. And our story ahead is described within the first 3 minutes of the part 2. This is building up of story, and here we are also building up our tensions using camera movements. First, the camera shoots from far. 2. We have a little close up, but do notice all our characters are little elevated, very minute, but yes, that counts. 3. Now when tension builds up, we have front angle shot describing the tension in characters, also building up tension in audience, eye to eye shot. Now it comes to this escape sequence of the characters where the showcases their skill, or let's call it character development phase. Followed by a sweet sound which actually makes us happy and doesn't feel like horror. And swiftly we go through further development where briefcase is lost, and we learn ABT the importance of briefcase with another go back in time thingy, but this time we are learning ABT dangerous thing. So our camera elevation is a little up from above to build little person value. Now for the next 5 minutes we are introduced to White Death, and then again, we are shown he is the main boss or the reason of the movie. By now jokingly we are introduced to every aspect of movie that will take place. Like how LNT will die and how White Death will die and how things will go wrong for Ladybug. But since it's a joke we really don't take it seriously. And because of this when it actually happens, we still see the movie as comedy action sequence. Not as some horror sequencing, because without our little introduction it would have been dark.
I guess you missed that episode of Thomas, did you?
I really must have, because that sounds dark as shit. Not up a sh-
Now again we have another introduction to the character, some faith he had. But this 3-minute character built up has hard faster music to really pull us into the actions and further development of the stories. Now for we are just having fun, a small built up. And further story development.
Hi, there's a gun under this.
It's the quiet car. Gotta use your small inside voice in here, son.
Now notice this, that when we are introduced to two opposite character why introduced even though they are fighting for killing each other, because. But we are in a fight zone, so here the action sequence that follows ahead has a monotonous Zen garden sound, so people are chilling and enjoying the actions. This plays a really vital part in storytelling. As soon as Lemon goes down, the quiet part goes down, now it just simple environmental sound. Now he starts building, sounds start building, because we are in an escaping situation. Here directory has put in extra efforts as we have two phases in sound design.
The White Death.
For every built up we have music, and for every detailing shot we have environment sound effects. That is really how Bullet Train made a really separate pressure in the audience. Now next 15 minutes are sweet spot for the movie as we have entered the hour mark, either we should be angry, amazed, in between a bigger transition. But here we are in a sweet spot because. It's an action comedy, the built up between the character has been resorted and now they together are fighting the bigger evil. Which had small in details like 10 seconds built, the alarm trigger. The cabinet access, as we are now introduced that train is being automatically operated. So the question arises what the director would showcasing us with this information. As even after losing a door it's still running. Coming forward to shootout scene which we don't know will happen or not. Here there is no sound. Why it's quite cheeky little detail, but no sound means no emotions. Which means no built up, we don't understand until there is sound, so this scene passes, and we hear sounds 3 minutes later when the work is done.
Performance.
How did you
leaving us
that?
Coming all together with nothing as in a spectre
I'm not
mode.
Sure.
Since the start we are in a spectre mode, so talking ABT lighting. Here we see the biggest change in lighting pattern, fill lights highlighting all subjects. All this blue lighting, but we see a little darker contrast on the girl who is the little shit. While Tangerine here has light blue shade, that's we our mind quickly shifted to Tangerine side, or we could say it stayed with Tangerine as we are not that dark. If you are, you would like this little girl, making you dark AF. Now the supreme light comes in. The only way I could think of reason why director really shifted the color pattern this hard is. To understand the light meaning the support, support meaning the father that has stepped on the train at 6:45 a.m. Now we will be a little fast. The all-father is the support, so this shade and the music choice is always light in weight also. Good for ears, I guess. This movie is funny, so even though you are supporting me in this, you should definitely see the film. Now when the enlightenment is being worked up, the sun rises in the background. As the ladybug realizes his fate in the morning mist, we know we are towards the end. Let's relook as these moments as enlighten happens. The music is rising up. And it rises all up as we see the climax of the movie.
May live in peace.
But just before the climax, everything is simply laid out for us, the information ABT, all of the assassins coming together.
If I could.
The need for everyone on this train.
Why do you do what you
This makes it relaxing because we aren't waiting for high-paced music to feel threatened, angry, empty, or just waiting for the end. This calls off made us relaxed, keeping in factor, hence the comedy and the fighting all together.
I brought them all here.
This again is A, but these are fast-paced sequences, so I'm going to showcase the best scenes and leave rest out for you. Wait. Before you leave, let me state the biggest factor for people to amaze this film.
It's fighting sequences.
Because never before we have ever seen these details and with such connectivity music, which is what we saw in a Japanese tune, which makes us part of this Japan bullet train background that we have seen. If it would have been some other English music, it would have been a shit movie. We were all jumping at the end. This was the tips and bits ABT, the bullet train. We had dived into the sequences as we learned what made the bullet train, actually the butcher train. The bullet train. Sorry, you should see this ending. Music by Dominic Lewis. Cinematography by Jonathan Sela. Director of Photography. Editing by Elizabeth Ronald's daughter. Casting by Lindsey Graham. Mary Vernew. Production design by David Schunemann. Art direction by Richard Bloom, Chris Farmer. Supervising art director Nicholas Plotquin. Set decoration by Elizabeth Keenan. Costume design by Sarah Evelyn.